St Paul's is a school of just over 1,100 young people, and we sit in the south side of Glasgow. And what we wanted to do is make sure we were creating opportunities for every single young person to achieve what they wanted to achieve and where they wanted to go. And it seemed very, very natural for us that the SCQF framework opened up those opportunities for us and made sure that we were able to show and demonstrate through our working with our business partners and with the colleges that one pathway was not the correct way to offer things in school.
The School Ambassador Programme seems a great way to promote the SCQF framework, and I feel that in the school we recognise that the traditional qualifications like your National Fives and your Highers and your Advanced Highers don't suit everybody in the school, so we wanted to try and make a more inclusive curriculum.
The theme of no wrong path is absolutely understood and known by everybody. It's really important for the parity of esteem that every course is given value and every young person is encouraged to look at what it is they are strong in and then to follow that pathway.
I'd say being an SCQF ambassador has helped me because I didn't really know about the framework until I got put as an ambassador, and then by doing that I'm able to spread it onto my peers because I know more about it.
We've helped them learn about the framework and help them just plan their pathways and what's best for them and their future.
I believe that with SCQF ambassadors, people have been made more aware that there's more than just your Nat 5s and Highers. There's also NPA courses and apprenticeships that you can do within the school.
The SCQF has allowed me to see different opportunities, because at first I was going to do higher PE, but then I realised I could do NPA exercise, fitness and leadership, which is just the same qualification basically, but it's got more practicality because you get to learn more about leadership and stuff like that, which will help me in the long run.
As part of being an SCQF ambassador school, our staff have been starting to look at other qualifications that are on the SCQF framework that are not the traditional qualifications, and we've been working together using the whole school development plan to embrace and develop new qualifications for our young people to be successful and achieve. And different departments have then looked within their own faculties at what else young people could do if they might not be able to achieve a National 5 or a higher. Can they get a Level 6 or a Level 5 in something? And this has helped us to raise our attainment.
My friend has taken criminology, but she didn't get maybe the grade she wanted last year, but she's now resitting, but she now also has the opportunity to go to college if she doesn't get the grades this year, to go to uni and still end up in the same place that she wants. With the SCQF, she has learned more about it and she's now aware of her other options.
Both colleges that we work with, our young people go to on Tuesday, Thursday afternoons, that's City of Glasgow College and also Glasgow Clyde College. A lot of young people who are studying a variety of different courses there. At various different SCQF levels, their policy is to offer them at the end of their success on that course a full-time course at the next level up in a similar subject area. So we've had great success with some of the young people who have managed to move into these full-time opportunities, and the benefit of them being able to do the college courses through school means they're used to the college environment.
The wide variety of people we have in the school and the amount of vastly different jobs and different things they want to do. People doing more physical things, somebody doing more academic, some people doing a trade or stuff like that. It helped you see where you had to go and what was it would take you there. So it kind of gave you an insight as what ways you could go that weren't just straight line academic.
We're delighted to receive our Gold Award. It's been a real celebration of all the hard work that's been going on in the school amongst our previous ambassadors and all the staff that we have. And we don't want to finish anything there. We're always looking forward to improve. But what we're doing this year is we're taking stock of where we're at, and we're going to be reflecting as a school and within our departments where we go next after this year.